Blue again. Alright. I kind of didn't do a proper introduction, I suppose. Maybe you know my name, you know that much. But, I'm really happy to be here today. I'm going to share some poetry with you guys. I hope you're into that. I know it's hot. But I started writing at about 4 years ago. And I never thought of myself as a poet. I went to school for comedy years and years ago. Turns out comedy is one of those things where if you suck at it, everyone will not laugh at you. So I switched to something a little less funny. But I was born in Niagara Falls. I lived in Caledonia for a long time and moved here when I was 12. I've been here ever since. And my writing pulls a lot from being here as a queer Indigenous person in an urban jungle, wrestling with longing and love. So I have some things that are longer, some things that are shorter. Anyway, I hope you enjoy it. I'll walk you through a little bit each step at a time. This is one of the first things I wrote, one of the first things I shared publicly. So I wrote it soon after I came out a couple of years ago en masse to my community. So I laid there in the dark. The only light was from a small flame. My insides began to roll. Life has a funny way of stealing you. Its slow abduction into responsibility and obligation created this vortex of numbness that tricked me into thinking I was doing just fine. Doing it all, taking care of business, keeping my shit together. Really though, I fell apart and turned off. It turns out that I'm not a faucet like I thought I could be. I fooled myself, thinking that I could just turn it down a few notches and be all right. After all, parenthood and heteropatriarchal marriage means sacrifice, right? Being the fullness of me felt so big and crushing back then. Staying in that chrysalis prison felt safer than the perceptions of selfishness I felt inside. But there is no faucet. It's a switch. Either I'm on or off. Now, after years of darkness, I was standing on the edge of hitting that switch for real this time. I mean, there were a few close calls before. However, it turned out that I was the one hitting the switch for others, while I stayed stumbling in the dark drought. I lost myself. In actual time, as she approached me in the glow of that small flame, I began to remember absolute perfection, a cascade of humanity that hit the switch. Thank you.